So welcome students in our the new video that is the answer key of practice 1.1. So in the first sum we have to given the name the property that used in the given sums. So first is -7 × 1 and then 1 × -7 -7/11 × 1 1 × -7/11, the answer is remaining same. So this is the multiplicative identity of the rational numbers. Is that clear? So next is -2 × 1/2 × -5/6. So this is the very clear that this is the associative property of the multiplication of the rational numbers. Is that clear? So next, plus the sign is same, it means associative property of addition. Okay, next, using the property, find the values. So firstly we find and we solve these two rational numbers 7/8 × -5/6 -2/3 2/9. So this is the distributive property of multiplication over addition. So we solve firstly these rational numbers, then add 2/9. So we get the answer, that is -157/14. Is that clear to everyone? So this is the B part of that sum. This sum is also used by the distributive property of multiplication over the addition, and we get the answer, this is 0. Now verify each of the following. This is our third sum. So verify, when we have to verify, solve left hand side and right hand side separately, then verify if the answer is same. Left hand side equal to right hand side, then the property is verified, and write the property name. If their answer is not same, left hand side is different to right hand side, then we say the property is not satisfied or not verified. So we have the associative property of the multiplication. We know associative property of multiplication of rational numbers is hold. So when we solve left hand side and right hand side, we get the same result. So we write here verified by the associative property of the multiplication of rational numbers. Is that clear? So in the B part, we have the distributive property over the addition. So when we solve this, so we have the left hand side. When we solve the left hand side, we got 207/28. Similarly, when we solve right hand side of the same sum, we get term 207/8 positive. So left hand side equal to right hand side, verified by the distributive property of the multiplication over addition, because this is the addition sign. So this is the addition. So next is distributive property of the multiplication over addition again. So left hand side equal to right hand side, you can see clearly. Okay, is that clear to everyone? So this is the D part of the third sum. This is again a multiplicative property, multiplication, distribution of multiplication over the addition. So left hand side again equal to right hand side, verified by the distributive property of multiplication over addition. Is that clear? So in the, now we move fourth sum. We have any three rational number A, B and C, and they are assigning the sum values of A, B and C, that is 5/8 to A, -3/4 to B and -1/2 to C. We check the properties that we discussed in the very first lecture of the rational numbers. So either the properties hold true, If the true, give the reason. If not true, then also give the reason. So, firstly, we discuss the associative property of addition, and we know that associative property of addition is hold in the integers, in rational numbers, in fractions. Okay. So, left hand side, solve the left hand side and right hand side. If you got the same result, then we say the yes, associative property of addition of the rational number is hold. So this is a D part of the fourth sum, that is distributive property of multiplication over addition. So we know that the distributive property of multiplication over addition is also hold in the rational numbers. So when we solve right hand side and left hand side separately, we get the same result. Next, distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. We know that distributive property of multiplication over subtraction is also hold. So B part is also true, D part is also true. Is that clear to everyone? Now this is the C part of the fourth sum, that is associative property of the subtraction. We know that associative property of subtraction of rational number or associative property of subtraction of integers is not hold. So left hand side, when we solve the left hand side and right hand side, we get the different results. So this is a false associative property of subtraction of the rational numbers, doesn't hold. Okay, is that clear to everyone? In the fifth sum, we find the additive inverse of the following. We know that the additive inverse, if the rational number in the positive, additive inverse is in the negative. If the rational number is negative, additive inverse is positive. So we find the additive inverse of 2 over 7, that is minus 2 over 7. Additive inverse of 3 over 16, minus 3 over 16, the inverse of minus 17 over 2, that is 17 over 2. Inverse of minus 29 over 8, that is 29 over 8. The inverse of minus 3 over 5, that is 3 over 5. Inverse of 1, 6 over 7, that is minus 1, 6 over 7. Or you can convert mixed fraction into improper fraction, then find the additive inverse. Choice is yours. You have two methods to solve the mixed fractions. Next is find the multiplicative inverse of the rational number. So multiplicative inverse is that when we number, when a rational number multiplied with its inverse and give 1 as answer. So minus 22. So minus 22, the multiplicative inverse of minus 22 is minus 1 over 22. Inverse of 22 over 3 is 3 over 22. You can clearly see in the answer key of the sixth sum. This is the multiplicative inverse of the rational numbers. Is that clear? Look at F part, that is 1, 5 over 6. So when we find the multiplicative inverse, we have to solve the mixed fraction into improper fraction. When we solve mixed fraction into improper fraction, we get 11 over 6. So the inverse of 11 over 6 is 6 over 11. Is that clear to everyone? So now move on the seventh sum, that is verify by minus x. So we replace the x by the given rational number and verify the answers. Is that clear? You can clearly see here all parts are solved. So in the eighth sum, that is a blanks, this is the answers of the blanks A, B, C, D, E, F and G. These are the answers of the blanks. Is that clear to everyone? So now ninth, 1 over 0, is 1 over 0 is a multiplicative inverse of 0? No, 1 over 0 is not a multiplicative inverse of 0 because division with 0 towards infinity, because division of 0 we know that is undefined, and no real number multiplied with 0 produce 1. We know that 0 ko kisi bhi number ke saath multiply karo. आपका आंसर कभी भी 1 नहीं आएगा. जीरो, कोई भी नंबर को 0 के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करके देखो, आपका कभी भी 1 नहीं आएगा, 0 ही आएगा. सो दैट्स व्हाई 1 ओवर 0 इज नॉट अ मल्टीप्लिकेटिव इनवर्स ऑफ द 0. So in 10th sum, we have to multiply 3 over 13 with the reciprocal of 9 over 26. So firstly, we find the reciprocal of 9 over 26, that is 26 over 9. Now multiply 26 over 9 with 3 over 13. 13 divides 26 on 2 and 3 divides 9 on 3. So 2 over 3 is our answer. So last sum of the practice 1.1, that is x plus y divide x minus y and assigning the value x 1 over 4, y 3 over 2. So firstly find x plus y 1 over 4, add 3 over 2, take the LCM of 4 and 2, that is 4, and that is 1 plus 6, 7 over 4. Then again 1 over 4 minus 3 over 2, because we have to find x minus y, that is 1 minus 6 over 4 minus 5 over 4. Now you can fill the value of x plus y and x minus y in the statement and get the answer. The answer is minus 7 over 5. Is that clear to everyone? This is the answer key of your practice 1.1. Thank you, and in the next video I will share the answer key of practice 1.2. Is that clear to everyone? Thanks for watching.